I think I'm losing my mind. Trying to stay inside the lines.
Good morning, Riverhawks!
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Charlotte. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Face the flag, put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated.
Attention current 7th graders, if you're interested in joining RioTV, make sure to join the information meeting on Tuesday at lunch.
VHS cheer tryouts are happening! There will be a parent and student meeting for tryouts today at 6 p.m. Watch this to learn more.
I did it my way, lie way too fast. But in my heart, I understand. I made my move, and it was all about you. Now I feel so far removed. You are the one thing in my way. 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 You are the one thing in my way.
Here it is, the moment you have all been waiting for. Our library March Madness is down to the final two. Who will be the champion of the year? Will it be Harry Potter, or will the Hunger Games pull off an underdog upset? You will decide.
Vote now through a Google form on a Google Classroom or in person in the library. Stay tuned to see who will win.
Hello, Riverhawks. If you're interested in playing golf for Valencia High School next year, we have spots available. Please send an email to Coach Waters at rwaters@hartdistrict.org.
Now, let's send it over to Character Dare.
Hey, Riverhawks! Welcome back to Character Dare.
Our dare for you this week is to help out anyone, such as your parents, guardians, friends, or even a stranger.
Helping out others can not only benefit them, but can help you feel good about yourself and what you did to help.
Here are some ways you can help others. You can hold a door open for them, help them clean up something, or even just help out with a simple task in general.
Helping out others is a great way to uplift the other person's mood and your own at the same time.
Well, that's it for this week's Character Dare. Don't forget to make someone smile.
Now back to the studio.
Today in Clubs and Activities, the Video Production Club is meeting in room D12, and the Yoga Club is meeting in room D4 from 2:45 to 3:30.
Here's your daily dose of positivity. And every day, there are 1,440 minutes. That means we have 1,440 opportunities to make an impact. Les Brown.
That's it for today. I'm Sarah.
And I'm Charlotte.
And we'll see you next time on RioTV.
If you're like most teens, you prefer to stay up late at night and sleep late in the morning. It's not because you're lazy or undisciplined. It results from the timing of your natural body clock, or circadian rhythm. A teen's body clock tends to be wired differently for sleep than the body clock of a child. In children, the brain typically sends sleep-promoting signals to the body early at night. But in teens, these sleepiness signals are often delayed until much later, which is why many teens prefer to be a night owl. The teen brain also tends to delay the alerting signals that tell the body when it's time to wake up, which is why teens often prefer to sleep later in the day. This late-to-bed, late-to-rise schedule can cause adults to think teens are unmotivated or undisciplined. The timing of the teen body clock often conflicts with an early morning school schedule. As a result, most teens are unable to get the sleep needed during the school week. The American Academy of Sleep Medicine recommends that teens should sleep 8 to 10 hours per night to promote optimal health. However, CDC data shows that fewer than 1 in 4 high school students get sufficient sleep on an average school night. Sleep is essential for teen health, well-being, and mood. Sleep also helps teens perform best at school and it enhances alertness for peak performance in sports and other activities. To help you improve your sleep, here are 10 tips for teens. Try to get some physical activity every day. Avoid caffeine after school, including sodas, coffee, and energy drinks. Limit after-school naps to 30 minutes or less, and avoid naps after 4 p.m. Have meals around the same time every day, and avoid eating too close to bedtime. Keep indoor lights dim at night. Put away your smartphone and other electronic devices at least 30 minutes before bedtime. Give yourself some time to relax and unwind before going to bed. Set a bedtime that will allow you at least 8 hours to sleep, and keep as close to it as you can. Get bright light every morning when you wake up to signal to your brain that it's time to be alert. Stick to your sleep schedule as closely as you can on weekends. Sleep should be one of your top health priorities. Let sleep recharge you tonight and every night.